Round two. I like this hand. Pretty much gonna like any hand with lands and a Seagate Oracle. Which is, I think, one of the strengths of this type of deck. It's just so consistent in the hands you keep and being able to find the cards you need. You rarely flood, you rarely get mana screwed. As opposed to, say, the aggro decks where you really need, you're at the mercy of drawing the right ratio of lands and spells, or the ramp decks where you have to get half mana acceleration and half threats in order to have a good hand. Also, playing that island on turn one was definitely a mistake because I have him to Torak in my deck, and I have Gerard's Verdict in my deck, so I should have played Underground Sea or possibly Drowned Catacomb. Alright, so I could play Lingering Souls, or I could play Seagate Oracle. I think I want to play Seagate Oracle because it's so good for me if I can find a Planeswalker here. No Planeswalker, but Temple of Enlightenment's pretty good for digging me one card deeper. Chromatic Lantern. So I guess what I'm worried about my opponent doing is casting his own Planeswalker. So let me try to establish a board presence via Brago. I'll attack for one. I'll play Brago. Combat damage to a player. Yeah, I mean, Brago with Seagate Oracle's really good combo anyway. And these green decks often don't play much removal at all. One, two, three. So, all right. I can Cyclonic Rift the Song of the Dryads. Exile any number of target non-land permanents, then return them. So Cyclonic Rift on the Song of the Dryads allows me to attack and blink my Seagate Oracle, but that's actually not super top priority. Instead, I can just play Lingering Souls and flash it back and have the option to make that play on a future turn. But I guess the first thing I should have done was my Scryland, since that's my plan anyway. Having the extra forest with the Brago is kind of nice also. One, two, three. Cool. Plus I can overload Cyclonic Rift. Like maybe end of next turn overload Cyclonic Rift. Yeah, that seems to be the play I want to make. I'll attack with three spirit tokens, then I'll chump block Beast, let him do whatever he does, and end of turn Cyclonic Rift. And that will, of course, bounce the Song of the Dryads. Ah, planes. Of course, my opponent already had access to any color of mana with Chromatic Lantern, but the planes reveals that his deck is not entirely mono green. All right, I'm okay with that. No reason to play Snapcaster first, although, I mean, blinking it with Brago is cool, but just doesn't do anything in this case. Sure. Interesting. I think compulsive research is. Can I go. I can him Snapcaster him. That's pretty nasty. I guess that's the best play. When you're ahead, you want to focus on reducing your opponent's resources instead of increasing your own. Plus, I get to see more about my opponent's deck this way. So my opponent has Noble Hierarch, Song of the Dryad, and an unknown card. Is that lethal? That should be lethal. Six flying. Oh no, you can block this Snapcaster. So that, therefore, consuming vapors. I should have done this first because now he can concede, whereas he might have shown me like two islands or something otherwise, and I'd have a little more information about his deck. Plains. All right, so I'm against a green-white deck, this to the best of my knowledge. My opponent can probably take better advantage of upheaval than I can. Attrition might be cool. Can board in attrition and board out what, like Gerard's Verdict, Inquisition. Yeah, Gerard's Verdict's probably just better than Inquisition almost any way you look at it. Could see boarding in one extra swamp because of the attrition. No, this is fine. Have to mulligan the one lander. This hand is pretty bad, but if my opponent has a slow draw, it'll be okay. Again, I should have played the swamp there in case I drew him the Torak. Wow, that's lucky. I thought for sure I was going to be facing down a 5-drop Planeswalker or something. All right. I mean, I guess I plus 2 the Jace, although I really don't want to give my opponent more cards when he has so much mana, so much more mana than me. But otherwise, I would just lose the Jace immediately. So this turn's going to be interesting. I mean, I want to plus the Jace. Well, I guess the fact that I drew Brago makes it a bit less interesting, but it would have been interesting if I drew a land there, because I would want a verdict, but I'd also want to plus Jace. So the verdict would make me want to cast it first, so he has to make his decision with less information and less options. But I would want to plus the Jace first in case I drew a card that I wanted to cast instead of the Verdict. So that would have been interesting. But I drew the Brago, so that's what I'm going to be casting. Let me first start by plusing the Jace. I don't want to minus and have the Jace die if he has Song of the Dryads for Brago. Vindicate's a good draw, especially with the Snapcaster in my hand. So I'm going to go for Godless Shrine. Play my 4-drop creature. And if he casts Song of the Dryads, it's not that bad for me because, ooh, that's pretty bad for me. I was going to say Song of the Dryads at least gives me one extra mana when I have a stacked hand and I'm drawing 2 cards per turn. Mana Tithe. All right, got to play around that one next game. My opponent's just really flooded or has all reactive cards, something like that. Or all 7 and 8 drops. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right. Might be time to finally cash in this Jace. This turn, probably all I can do is vindicate the Fraelease. So I think it's time to accept that Jace is going to die and just minus 1. Sure. So I'm really choked on white mana. Have to make sure that I cast a white spell every turn. So only one creature attacking the Jace. I could just block the Snapcaster, but I think I'm okay with this. Jace dies. Opponent has 3 cards. Now, I don't think I have to. I think I can wait one turn before I cast Banishing Light. It's much better to Snapcaster Vindicate, keep the Banishing Light in my hand, because A, the longer I wait in the Banishing Light, the fewer number of turns it is for my opponent to kill it. And B, the Snapcaster can trade with one of these 1-drop creatures. Sure. So I take a big hit here, and then I guess I Snapcaster Vindicate the Elspeth. Seagate Oracle. So maybe in that case, I play Seagate Oracle, and then I Banishing Light the Elspeth. Seems slightly preferable. Hmm. Both these are pretty bad. I'll take the temple. That's good. That is a card. Alright, please don't kill the Banishing Light. Don't do anything bad to me. Eternal Witness, the Fraylease. Destroy Banishing Light. Elspeth Jump. I guess as long as I don't die, the Massacre Room is going to be so good next turn. I don't like this. Okay. So now I'm taking 3. I'm down to 4. I have to Snapcaster Vindicate the Angel. It's not that bad. It's not that bad. Alright, so same situation as last turn, just please let me survive. Alright, I mean, I'll block. I guess, there could be a case for not trading the Snapcaster there and just being at 1 life. Yeah, I mean, that's probably better. 4, 8 mana. Let's do the Baleful Strix first. So I have to fade only one draw step, actually, and then the Profane Command should be lethal. Because I have 9 lands in play, the 10th in my hand, so minus 8 life, give all my guys fear. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, I think I win. So target player loses X life. These 3 creatures gain fear. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that'll take him down to 8. Attack for 6, 7, 8. That's 16. All right, that was a good game. And I'm on to the finals.